didn't you tell her to stay the hell home where she belongs? Said Carlson. You let her hang around the bunkhouse, and pretty soon you're going to have something on your hands, and you won't be able to do nothing about it. Curly whirled on Carlson. You keep out of this unless you want to step outside. Carlson laughed. You damn punk, he said. You try to throw a scare into Slim, and you couldn't make it stick. Slim throwed a scare into you. You're a yellow-bellied frog. I don't care if you're the best welter in the county. You come after me, and I kick your damn head off. Candy joined the attack with joy. Glove full of Vaseline, he said disgustedly. Curly glared at him. His eyes slipped on Pass and lighted on Lenny. And Lenny was still smiling with delight at the memory of the ranch. Curly stepped over to Lenny like a terrier. What the hell are you laughing at? Lenny looked blankly at him. Huh? Then Curly's rage exploded. Come on, you big bastard! Get up on your feet! No big son of a bitch is gonna laugh at me! I'll show you who's yellow! Lenny looked helplessly at George, and then he got up and tried to retreat. Curly was balanced and poised. He slashed at Lenny with his left, and then smashed down his nose with a right. Lenny gave a cry of terror. Blood welled from his nose. George, he cried, make them let me alone, George! He backed until he was against the wall, and Curly followed, slugging him in the face. Lenny's hands remained at his sides. He was too frightened to defend himself. George was on his feet, yelling, get him, Lenny! Don't let him do it! Lenny covered his face with his huge paws and bleated with terror. He cried, make him stop, George! Then Curly attacked his stomach and cut off his wind. Slim jumped up. The dirty little rat, he cried. I'll get him myself.